Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Matt Nago, Superintendent Sangamon Unified School District.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Sangamon Unified School District, the Sangamon Unified School Board, it's an honor to say a few words about Lieutenant Commander Quinone. Lieutenant Commander Quinone is one of the most courageous men I've had the pleasure of meeting. Not enough can be said about Commander's service to both Sangamon Unified and our country. Commander Quinone has served in every major conflict since 1990. Desert Storm, Desert Shield, Operation Iraqi Freedom, and Operation Afghan Freedom. He has served this country faithfully for 23 years and retired as Lieutenant Commander in 2012. Upon retirement from service, Commander Quinone came to Sangamon Unified on July 13, 2012, where he faithfully has served for 6 years the students of Sangamon Unified School District. In those 6 years, Lieutenant Commander Quinone served the role of Department Chair for 5 of those 6. Commander spent his entire career either in service of his country or in service of the students of Sangamon Unified's NJROTC program. It is said there is no higher service than service to God, country, and its children. Commander Quinone has served all 3 of those with honor, grace, and courage. I will always remember Commander Quinone's General Session speech, where he addressed all 2,000 employees. In his speech, Lieutenant said, "When life gets tough, tie a knot and hang on." Commander, you are the greatest example of courage, compassion, strength, and perspective that I have ever had the pleasure of meeting. Thank you for your service to your country. Thank you for your service to the students of Sangamon Unified School District. It's been an honor, sir. Thank you.
It is very unfortunate that I have to leave Sanger NJROTC after only 6 years. I'm not leaving because I want to, but because I have to. My MS has gotten the best of me, and physically it is becoming tough, and I don't want the unit to suffer anymore. I'm currently in the process of pursuing HSCT, stem cell therapy, with chemotherapy, outside the country in either Mexico or Russia, as this is my only and last hope to help stop the disease progression, and am hoping to reboot my body and even halt MS altogether. It is very expensive and a very risky procedure, but one that is worth it if it can halt the disease and allow me to regain what I've lost in only 4 years. I'm hoping that I get approved and accepted into one of these 2 stem cell programs, and am very optimistic it could change my life. It truly saddens me to have to leave, and I wish I could have stayed here for many years. I am really going to miss everyone. I want to take this opportunity to thank a few people who have been important in my 6-year tour here at Sanger High and the NJROTC program. First, I would like to thank my assistant, AT1 Brett Johnson. Your support during my tenure, especially over the last few years since MS has crept up on me, is the most appreciated. You have gone above and beyond your job and have truly taken over the unit these past few months. I really appreciate everything you have done for me and for the unit. Your support has truly been a blessing, and I thank you. I also want to thank all faculty and staff at the district and high school for your support during my most challenging years. Dan Chacone, John Tillison, Ed Martinez, and Matt Nabo, I thank you all so much. I could not have made it this long without your support. And John, thanks for being a champ when it came to receiving all those early morning texts from my wife, letting you know if I was gonna make it in or not. She always felt bad and felt like she was bugging you, but in the end, your support and understanding means more than you will ever know. Most important, I want to thank all the cadets in the unit. You have all given me unbelievable support. To Corbin and the leadership staff, thank you for all the help over this past year. You all have been a tremendous help in getting work done. I would like to point out a few cadets who have been most helpful during my struggles. From in the morning, with Catalina and Connie helping me out of the car, Catalina would even sometimes put on my socks and shoes, and it was easier for me to get in the car to come to work without those on. Chris would always say, "Who puts on their teacher's socks and shoes?" Well, Catalina does. Thank you so much. It meant a lot to have such caring students help me in the morning. I really appreciate you both to help. I want to thank Shady Zhang, who would help me with my lunch every day and heat up my soup. Sometimes I would not even have to ask her. It would just be waiting on my desk. And Jonathan. Jonathan Ramirez has been an absolutely amazing student and also a friend. He has a huge heart made of gold. He is the most caring and supportive student, and he has become like family to me. My wife adores his caring heart and says there is no one like him, and he is truly one of a kind. She and I will truly miss him and promise to keep in touch once he graduates. I want to thank him for all his support and especially those shoulder massages. I will definitely miss those. Tammy Wolf and the Chamber, thank you so much for all the years of support. You have been an absolute blessing to the unit and have unconditionally supported the program and the cadets. Thank you for selecting me as a 2015 Grand Marshal for the Toyland Parade. It was an honor. The entire community of Sanger has been very supportive to NJROTC, and we appreciate it. JD Bennett, thank you for supporting the unit for all these years. I thank you for all the help and guidance and assistance you have given me over these years. I really appreciate everything you have done for me, as I could not have done it without your help. To Al Sanchez and Jesse Solorio, and to any staff who have helped me in my time of need, thank you for coming to my aid when I have needed an extra hand or needed help getting up when I was weak. I thank you for everything you have done for me. Finally, I want to thank my marksmanship coach, Mrs. Nettie Drake. Without you, the program would not exist. You have truly been an absolute angel in helping me out and taking over the practices as well as the competitions. I don't know how I can thank you enough and know that you have been a blessing to me and the program. You have gone above and beyond your expectations as a coach, and you have volunteered so much of your time. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart and know that I appreciate it all. Thank you all, and I really appreciate everything you have given me and the support I have received from everyone, staff, students, and even parents. Again, it saddens me to leave, and I'm hoping my health will improve during stem cell therapy, and ask for everyone's prayers and support for me as I start a new journey to get better. Thank you.